Hey guys, welcome to the channel. I'm Steve, big fan of Rhythmic Gymnastics and Lena's channel. Hope you had a good New Year's celebration despite ongoing difficulties with a global pandemic. However, we have another news release from World of Gymnastics. We do want, however, to round things up for 2020. In this video, we'll discuss a lot of interesting, funny, but unfortunately sad things. So get some popcorn, get comfy, and let's get started. Recently, a new video with Ekaterina Selezneva was released on the Olympic channel. This time, Katya described gymnast in her own words. She states that Dina Averina always achieves her goal, and Irina Averina is kind person who will always help. Lara Kramarenko is unique gymnast, according to Katya, who does what no one is doing now. She also spoke about Alina Kabaeva and Margarita Mamun. On channel Ada Amor, Alexandra Soldatova starred in an interesting video where she shared the difficulties she faced and that she had to overcome in the last 3 years whilst she was training. The video is very motivating and very useful words for everyone. I particularly love such things. I'm very glad that Sasha openly helps everyone who, like her, has faced problems with eating disorders. Low bow and gratitude to Sasha and everyone who helps her to promote this. Now some next good news about the competition next year. The traditional Miss Valentine held in the city of Tartu is planned to be held from 25th to 28th of February. So it's nice to hear that next year promises, hopefully, to become realistic events. And some other news, Morinari Watanabe, the president of Gymnast Federation, in his final message mentioned that after the Olympic year, changes will be made to the rules, including restoring a separate score for artistry and increase the number of dance floors, as well as some difficulty limitations. Hence, the new rules after the Olympic Games will probably be interesting. Could you please write in the comments below what you think? Would you be happy with the changes? Because there are a lot of people who wrote and spoke. Nowadays, gymnastics is like a circus, and innovation once again will bring back more feminine gymnastics. The International Olympic Committee has already begun work on the Olympic program for Paris 2024. On the agenda for Rhythmic Gymnastics, the International Olympic Committee states that it will remain in a program, but the places quotas will be reduced. So the next Olympic Games there will be only 94 places for gymnasts. There is also no plans to add individual types. Those gymnasts are still participating in 2 medals in all around for individual and group. Furthermore, International Olympic Committee has not yet released any information about including men into the competition programs. I had a separate video on my channel, well, not me, but Lena, so please check it out, where she talked about the fact that they planned to add male rhythmic gymnastics the Olympic sports. Moving on, new disciplines will not be added. Park 2, acrobatic gymnastics and aerobic have applied. However, there will still be new sports such as surfing, skateboarding and rock climbing, although they will first appear in Tokyo in 2021. Breakdancings will be added as well. The number of athletes in connection with coronavirus will be reduced to 10,500. We do have some interesting news about Azerbaijani gymnasts. Somehow completely missed the fact, but for me it's very curious. The gymnast of Azerbaijan performing the group program at the European Championships this year did not only remember their minimalistic swimsuits for second exercise, they had no less interest costumes and moreover were associated with the Russian star Olga Buzova. As the coach of Azerbaijan, Mariana Viseleva wrote in her Instagram, it was Olga who inspired her stage costume from the concert tour of the coaches to new swimwear for the team. Write some comments if you know or knew and how you inspired. Is it cool for gymnasts to do this in your opinion or is it bad? Please share your opinion. Some new information states that Maria Vasileva, the head coach of Azerbaijani national team, will become the manager of the Israeli gymnasts. According to the information, it is not yet entirely clear whether she will leave the national team of Azerbaijan or not, but most likely she will simply supervise the national team of Israel. Marina trained part of Bulgarian national team and now leads the Azerbaijani national gymnastic team, which shows very good results at the world level. Well, at least at last tournament, everyone was talking about them, for sure, especially when they arrived with these unusual swimsuits. So probably in the near future, it's worth expecting something unexpected from the Israel national team. Keep an eye out. Judging by the article, Marina will begin work already for the next Olympic Games in Tokyo. While we're talking about Olympic Games, it's time for the loud news for the last month. Finally, after a long time, the Court of Arbitration for Sport published the decision. The case of WADA versus RUSADA. The punishment became less severe, but from December 17, 2020 to December 16, 2022, Russian national team has no right to represent Russian Federation at the Olympic Games and World Championships, which turns out at the next major tournament, Russian gymnasts will perform only under neutral flag. So that means that Russian athletes will perform at Tokyo Summer Olympic Games 21 under neutral flag, as well as Beijing Winter Olympics in 2022. Also, the anthem of Russia is not allowed at major tournaments. However, I can say that the decision turned out to be much softer than we originally anticipated, since such restrictions do not apply to the Youth Olympic events, the European Games, and qualifying tournaments. Also, restrictions will only last 2 years, not four. The some relaxed rules applied to the athletes' sports uniforms. Despite the fact that all athletes from Russia, suits may have Russian tricolor and the color of the uniform and the name of the country may also be present. In fact, the country has not really received particular dire punishment, in my opinion. Irina Alexandra, by the way, spoke about the situation and said this would not affect the Russian national rhythmic gymnastics team in any way. Gymnasts will perform at the Olympics and World Championship just under a neutral flag. And as she says, all the fans know who the gymnasts represent. There are, however, some concerns about the decision because the president of Russia, Vladimir Putin, will not be able to attend the games. The arbitrage court forbidden him to attend the Olympics. And not just the president. The ban also applies in general to all senior officials, ministers, deputies, and the state duma and the prime minister. Would you believe it or not, but there's plenty of people who dissatisfied with the decision to soften the rules on Russia. However, court argues its decision by arguing that mitigation is necessary to bring cultural change in Russia and also encourage the next generation of Russian athletes to participate in pure international sports. Please comment below, what do you think about the punishment? Was it mitigated or should have left everything to the maximum? Also, would it be good to know your opinion? What do you generally think and feel about the fact that Russian athletes will perform under neutral flag for the next two Olympic Games? Russia was not the only country punished by IOC. Belarus was also, because there is true political discrimination. The IOC accused the Committee of Belarus that the athletes of Belarus were not protected from political discrimination within the country. There was also an investigation, though in the end, faster and faster, the punishment is not so harsh. So Belarus will ignore the NOC for some time. The talk about international competition will be suspended. Athletes are not prohibited from participating at Olympic Games. However, all scholarship will not be paid through NOC, but directly to the athletes. The Board of Olympic Committee Belarus will also not be able to go to the Olympics. The sanctions are temporarily and will be lifted at the discretion of International Olympic Committee. So while athletes train and prepare, the Olympic Committee, in my opinion, is doing some strange things, depriving different people from the opportunity to participate in Olympics. I would, on contrary, like them to create a proper condition for successful performance of athletes and not interfere with them. Moreover, in the world of gymnastics, another piece of news related to the Board of Gymnastics. As you remember, quite recently, Mariana Viseleva ended her career and took up a managerial position at Bulgarian Gymnastic Federation. So another athlete, this time the gymnast of Georgia, Salom Pazhava, took the post of vice president of rhythmic gymnastics of her country. True, Salom has not yet completed her career, so in fact she will combine combine work and professional sports. It is a bit of a rarity. Let's hope that this will not be the reason for the early end of this career of Solomon. Meanwhile, in Russia, the elections of new presidents were held at the Gymnastic Federation. And I think it's no surprise to anyone that post was again taken by Irina Alexandrovna Vina Rismanova. There was no competitors in the election, and uncontested bias happened. So Irina Alexandrovna has been holding this post since 2008. Let's rejoice and think about this topic, of course. Irina Alexandrovna is a good manager and does a lot for gymnastics all over the world. But if you rely on history, the absence of competition and change of power does not lead to anything good, really. I say there's nothing too much intriguing about it. Now we'll move to some sad news. Unfortunately, on December 16, Odette Richard, a gymnast playing for South Africa, died. Odette was one of the most successful athletes in the world. She competed in several world championships, as well as took part at Beijing 2008 Olympic Games. Odette was suffering with eating disorder, passed away at the age of 32. However, the cause of death has not yet been determined. Well, this video has come to an end. Take good care of yourself and your loved ones, and remember that Lena and I love you all very much. And we hope to see you in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button if you like the video. See you in the next one.